good evening to Mr. Carl Hyde in the studio.
How you doing, man?
I'm doing fine, man. Welcome to our humble studio on location.
This is mental. I said, come and do some live radio, but this is a party.
This is a party, right?
This is great.
Yeah, that's how we do it in Holland. So, a warm welcome.
Thank you very much. It's good to be back.
It's good to have you on the show. In the beginning of their 20s, they say, okay, which DVD should I watch before I go to party? So I make copies or buy them copies from the Everything album from Underworld, because it's one of the most influential DVD soundtracks ever.
Thank you.
Thank you for producing that.
Thanks, man. It was a great experience to do that, and I think it's a lovely to have a document of a live show from Underworld.
Yeah, we are in the middle of a revolution with this whole electronic music thing that's going on for about 20 years now.
They said it would go away.
Yeah. And what happened, it only grew bigger.
That's fantastic, eh? Yeah. Well, your people are having a good time. No, people don't want to stop having a good time.
Yeah, and it's still like renewing itself every time, and that's the most fascinating thing about it.
Isn't
it? It never stops.
That's beautiful. I mean, when we first got involved in dance music, the great thing about it was about the next record, not so much what people look like or about staying the same. It was about changing and evolving. That was the beautiful thing about it.
Yeah, what was the flow of the beginning of the years of Underworld when you produced records? What was the flow? Did you do like every day studio time, or was it just like a few days every month to work together?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. Rick did every day studio time. I generally spent my time mostly drunk in London. It's not quite like that now, but yeah, Rick spent every day just working on our music.
Yeah. And how does it feel after all those years? Because you did the sound check this afternoon, and I saw the stage where you guys are going to perform tonight.
Yeah.
It looks huge.
It's beautiful. The way people have looked at the production. See, there's another thing about doing dance events. People care about the way things look. The first rave I ever went to, it was like the best rock concert circus I'd ever been to. It was better than any rock concert. And you come into these rooms, and they're just so exciting to look at. It's everything for the eyes and the ears. It's a great night out.
Yeah, it's great for your brains to process all that information when you go out on a night like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, and congratulations on the fantastic news. I got it like yesterday that Underworld will be the music directors for the Olympic Games 2012.
Yeah, it's mad. How mad is that?
How did that come together?
A lot of years, 15 years working with Danny Boyle, who is the director, creative director of the
Olympic Games. And a friend of yours as well.
He's a good friend. He's become like another member of the band in a way. Yeah. But we've made a lot of films together and then big theatre productions. And this year we had a big production at the National Theatre in London, and that was like the dry run for the Olympics. I think that was the real test, and we came out of that, and he offered us the gig.
Yeah. Do you still follow all the recent developments in music? Do you still follow certain labels or artists?
We do, not as much as we used to. So we rely on a lot of friends. Our friends at JBO Records and other record labels, they send us stuff, and we still post links to other artists on our website every day, and getting back into radio shows when we can. But the Olympic Games is going to take up all of our time. You know?
That will be amazing to do.
It's kind of bizarre, you know. It's nothing like we've ever done before. It's doing music for the theatre is a bit like it, because you're working with live action and you're not locking up to picture, or you're not making stuff for the dance floor. But it's huge. This is vast. It's 4 billion plus people watching this thing, and it happens only once.
Yeah, only once. Only once in a lifetime event.
That's right.
Yeah. This month also sees the release of two new Underworld compilations.
Yeah.
Some new material on the way as well.
There is new material, but most of what we're doing is going into the Olympic Games. We're still writing, and things come out sideways, but the majority of what we're doing is focused on the opening of the Olympics, and we're taking most of next year just to do the Olympics. As soon as it's finished, we're going to take a break, and then we're going to come back with a new show.
Amazing. Mr. Carl Hyde, thank you, and have a great, great revolution tonight.
Hey, thanks, man. Thanks for your support.
Okay. And let's play Always Love the Film, because I loved it.
Woo-hoo!
So people give it up for Mr. Carl Hyde in the studio.
Dance Department.
Time Warp Holland. Underworld. Richie Houghton. Chris Liebing. Paul Rich. Karl Rotte. Lauhaus versus Boris Werner. Darko Esser versus